39 laps is going to be the race distance here at Canadian Tire Motorsports Park. 42 cars, actually only 41 cars, lined up behind the pace car as they head through turn 9, the second part of the S's, and into White's Corner. Pace car is off. Zayden Davidson didn't make the start, couldn't get that car fired, actually, from the pit lane. But the green flag is out, and Ryder Smith and Carlin Dumoulin lead them down to begin HARC Canada's 2016 season. Carlin Dumoulin looks to slip in front of the 7, but no, the 7 is still there as they head through turn 1 and up towards turn 2, one of the tightest sections on the course. It's very difficult to make a pass traveling through this corner, but Gerald Reddington is alongside Mike Doan. In fact, all of the top three rows were all experienced drivers heading in, but Santa Cruz is already up, battling for a position in the top five with Matthew Nicholson in the 43. Carlin Dumoulin managed to clear Ryder Smith through Quebec Corner and down through turn 4 and into turn 5. He's got a commanding lead over the 7 for this first lap. Mike Doan now going for second position off of Moss Corner and beginning the long trek down the Mario Andretti straightaway. Looks like he's going to get it. Didn't even manage to get up through turn 2 cleanly on the first lap as Krasta and Nutt make some contact, and that's Nutt and Shepard off the road. Aiden Shepard, a completely innocent victim there in the 14 machine. Got that car all set up, had a pretty bad qualifying effort, and is now going to go out of the race on lap number 1. What a shame. Ryder Smith giving Mike Doan a big push coming up towards turn 8, and Doan's inside. Heading into the S's, Carlin Dumoulin forced to secede that position to the 72 car. The 7 runs wide though, and after contact with Matthew Nicholson in the 43, the 7 is in the tire wall. That's the pole sitter out of the race on lap number 1. At best, he's going to come home in around 40th position. Almost no points for the 7, a terrible start to the year. And I thought that some of these more experienced drivers would know better than to do something like that on lap 1, but apparently I was wrong. And Mike Doan is going to come through with the lead onto lap number 2 through Clayton Corner. Carlin Dumoulin still sitting in second, and it's it's Gerald Reddington in the 99 just behind front, and it's Mike Doan and Carlin Dumoulin racing side by side now down the Andretti straightaway. Doan's held onto the lead for the past couple of laps, but now Carlin Dumoulin's got some help from Gerald Reddington in the 99. The 99 actually can't choose a lane here, kind of looking between them, trying to figure out which driver to go with. The 72 squeezing the 1 all the way down to the white line there. Allie Nelson is also with these top three, and that beautiful number 96 car, I believe that's Denali Tanana, is the car which that is based off of this year. New manufacturer Denali in the HARC series for this year. The 01 of Jonathan King having a pretty good start to the day in the 01 machine, passing Santa Cruz for that fifth position. And it's Bill Littlejohn making his way up into the top 10, nearly into the top 5 now in that 30 machine. Did not have a chance to do particularly well in the season finale last year at this very track. It's funny, we finish off the 2015 season here, and now we start off the 2016 HARC Canada season back at Canadian Tire Motorsports Park. Littlejohn got taken out around the first pit stop in the finale last year. Takes a peek on the 82, has to back out of that in a hurry, and it's DJ Harris and Matthew Nicholson racing side by side into Moss Corner just behind them. The good racing is simply not constrained to the front of the pack. Near the middle, Mike Wisnowski is racing side by side with Brandon Krasta in the 09. Krasta had a fairly good year last year, coming 12th in points. Nothing too notable as far as individual runs though, and I think the 09 really wants to change that for this year. Michael Kane, other than his pole at Homestead Miami, did pretty much nothing last year. Was a bit of a nuisance in some spots, but not nearly as much as he was in 2014. Some real improvement for that driver. Spencer Fullerton trying to make his way up a few spots. He's typically been very good at road courses. Last year, tended to be pretty good at dirt tracks, actually, capturing a couple of wins at both Lakewood Speedway in Atlanta, Georgia, as well as Indiana State Fairgrounds. Since his crash on lap number one, Mark Nutt has re-caught the very tail end of the field, currently sitting behind Henrietta Fitzwater in the 61. A lot of the series 18 rookie drivers for HARC Canada are at the tail, but so are a lot of the more experienced drivers. Luca Obrovac, I'm sure, is not used to being this far back. He's hoping to discontinue his trend of very mediocre performances from last year, the 2014 champion, looking to return to form. As is the 2012 champion, Demir Bejenov. He had a fairly good year last year, competed well at some tracks that he normally wouldn't have, like dirt tracks, short tracks, and speedways, where he actually captured a win at Vernon, a half-mile track in British Columbia, looking to do well, but had some trouble in qualifying, spun the car out, actually, during his qualifying run, and as a result, started last today. He's been trying to pick his way up through some cars, so far, somewhat ineffectively. But we're only an eighth of the way through this race, so lots of time still to go. Daniel Voyle's back here as well. That's Benoit Irvine, a new rookie in the 15 car. The French driver looking to make a name for, I think it's himself, this season. Nick Guerra is racing alongside Sidney Kress in the 21 for position. And Dumian's managed to lead for the last few laps. But here comes Gerald Reddington with a charge in the 99, again down the Andretti straightaway. Quite a good place to pass, it seems, thus far in the race. These top four of Endumian, Reddington, Doan, and Nelson, all four of them with experience, have pulled away a little bit over some of the other drivers. Nicholson and Littlejohn, I saw, are trying to make their way forward. Some near contact between Reddington and Endumian there through turn 8, and Dumian needs to be a little bit more careful to avoid getting the same fate as Ryder Smith got on the opening lap by running a little bit wider through turn 8 if he can with a car on the inside. Doan back up in a second down the shorter front straightaway and into turn 1. As I said, Littlejohn in the 30 and Nicholson in the 43 desperately trying to get back to those top four for position. That's not how you do it, as Nicholson nearly just dumped Littlejohn into the wall between turn one and Clayton Corner. Littlejohn, a miraculous save there, probably used some of his dirt track experience there, holding on to fifth position. Great job by him to do that. Santa Cruz still holding on to a good position in that McDonald's sponsored number 82, showing that she has some talent to be a contender in this HARC Canada Championship. DJ Harris in the 36, still trying to make his way forward. He's got lots of time to do it, but nearly constant side-by-side action back in this pack. Skyla Johnson did not start very well in that 29, but she seems pretty much unbeatable on this Andretti straightaway. No matter where she seems to come out of the corner, she always seems to be able to make at least one pass down this straight. One of the best cars in the engine department, it appears, in this opening round. Tire strategy seems to be a lot less important than we saw it be in last year's finale, where drivers would lose as much as 10 seconds racing on old tires. These guys just now focusing on really just giving it their all. And again, we're seeing some great action up here at the front. Carl Endumian and Mike Doan are side by side down the Andretti straightaway. Once again, it's Gerald Reddington in the lead. He won 3 races last year in the first 9 races and held on to the points lead for the vast majority of the second half of the season. Got into a little bit of a slump and ended up finishing a little bit behind in points. Still a top 5 in points though last year. And again, trying to start off the year with a bang. Ran a little wide through the S's, and as a result, Carl Endumian has the inside for turn 1, and Endumian back into the lead. Nelson looking to get in the third pass. Doan, not sure if he's going to be able to do so. Doan has the inside into Clayton Corner. But if Nelson can make the outside stick, she might be able to get into third. Yes, the 96 has got third, heading into Quebec Corner, an early apex corner. You can really crack the throttle coming out of this corner. And it's Endymion still with the lead. Currently on board a new driver, Gavin Moore, in the 10 car, sitting behind the 93 of Annie Thomas. Thomas goes to protect there as Gavin looked to the outside through turn four, again takes the defensive line into turn five. Of course, Annie Thomas might just be looking for a position up on John King right in front of her, but that was alongside the 10 car at the moment is the 8 of Lucas Knight, driving one of the new Dodge Challengers that is racing this season. Lucas Knight out of British Columbia. His teammates also in this race not doing quite as well, but a beautiful paint scheme. Nice to see Dodge on board as a manufacturer for this year. Doan with a very late move into the S's, once again catches Endymion sleeping. Endymion, as per usual, gives the 72 room a lot of respect between these two drivers. They've been racing each other since they both started back in 2014. Doan's gonna lead at the line, yet another lead change, as back behind they continue to race and try and get their way back up towards the top four. It's still Matthew Nicholson heading this pack. DJ Harris, though, up here as well, as the top few are battling. That's Carl Endymion alongside Gerald Reddington in the 99. I think the 99 tried to follow Doan through through turn one. Looks like it's going to be unsuccessful, but the 99 with the inside through Quebec Corner, and Endymion's going to hold Gerald off for the time being. Skyla Johnson is up into seventh position in that 29. I told you that she was going forward earlier on, seems to make a pass every single lap. Now looking on the outside of DJ Harris, it would be an incredible move to see her get it done from the outside through Moss Corner. That's extremely difficult to do. Looks like it's going to be unsuccessful this time around. Bill Littlejohn's up the inside, but the 30 had the run going on to the Andretti straightaway, and the 29 just drove right back by the 30 like he was standing still and is now going back after Nicholson and Harris. I tell you, the 29 is going to be someone to watch in just a few laps if Johnson continues at this pace. They're at it yet again, boys, as Endymion alongside the 72 once again through turn one. I cannot believe that we're seeing such great racing here up at the front through sections of the track where you normally don't see a lot of passing. The one in the 72 still side by side out of Clayton Corner. Doan's going to be having a bit of a deficit through Quebec Corner. He had to run the normal patch. Endymion had the grip patch on the inside there, and Endymion sweeps back into the lead. Got to watch out for a late charge down into turn four from the 72. Manages to protect that position, but here comes Gerald Reddington with an aggressive move up the inside of the 72 through Moss Corner. And if Endymion's not careful, Reddington could get both of them. Reddington very, very fast through the corners, it does appear, and not too shabby on the straights either thus far in the race. Reddington still driving for CA Motorsports, but has changed manufacturers for this year, now driving a Ford Mustang instead of a Camaro, his normal Camaro that he's driven the last couple of seasons. Actually, he drove a Chevy Lumina back in 2014. But either way, the 99 back into the lead. It might just be still alongside the 1. And Endymion always seems to end up on the outside, heading into White's Corner, the final corner on the track. And Endymion gets beat at the line once again. And Endymion, I'm sure, is going to have PTSD if he loses the race like this. Got a rather scary group of rookies and experienced drivers alike battling it out for around the 16th spot. That's Joshua Ciculli, a rookie driver in the 07 car, showing what he has at the front of this group. Mike Wisnowski continues to have a fairly good run to start the year. Alex Wheeler and Michael Kane side by side. Not too worried about those guys. Kane, I'm always worried about, but, well, that's besides the point. James Shelley in the 11 is here as well. Matt Duncan in the 99 just behind the 11. Might take a look down into turn four, and the 11 forced to run a little bit wide, but he's gonna have the optimal line heading into Moss Corner, and he's probably gonna get that position back, plus perhaps another one from the 69 of Wheeler. If Wheeler isn't too careful, Wheeler, the Massachusetts driver, having an all right start to the year, didn't do too much last year, but other than changing sponsorships a lot and having those beautiful Ford Mustang schemes on that car at all times. Stringer by the 99 for position. Mike Doan sneaked by Carlin Dumian out of Moss Corner and is now reeling in the 99 of Gerald Reddington, despite not using his draft. I'm not sure why he didn't there. Not sure whether he just wasn't sure whether he was cleared in Dumian or not. But either way, Reddington has a pretty big slip up there through turn 8. Carlin Dumian, I think he's just too used to running the outside through this section, because I'm pretty sure that most drivers would have been able to get underneath the 99 there. And Dumian maybe just looking to relax for these laps before the pit stop. Of course, just trying to save his stuff, likely for the final few laps. That's probably a safe way to go, looking at all the very hard racing we've had at the front so far. And as a result of all that hard racing, that Bill Littlejohn has re-caught the top three in the 30 car, looking very strong today. Skyla Johnson, up from around 20th spot at the start of this race, has passed more than one car a lap and has now cracked the top five and is within sight of Mike Doan's rear view mirror, I imagine. And into Moss Corner, let's see what the 29 has down the straight. Nelson has lost a couple of positions lately, not seeming to perhaps have used up her stuff a little bit early on this run, or maybe she's just not been able to keep up with these guys in the corners. Not sure whether they're going to have to make an adjustment during the pit stop or not. But again, here comes the 29 up the outside of the 30 with some drafting help from Endumian. That's the 99 rather of Gerald Reddington. I get them confused, they look so much alike. Is going after Mike Doan once again. Takes a bit of a defensive line. I thought he was just taking a defensive line by the down the Andretti straightaway. Turns out, no, he was going for a pass for the lead. And Dumian this time is going to follow him through. I think he just wants to get out of the sight, out of the path of Skyla Johnson, who is tearing through this group. Spencer Fullerton has continued to lose positions, actually, over the course of this race. Currently around 27th. Sawyer Girl sitting 28th. Really disappointing for him after a top 10 in the season finale last year. That's Alex Tanker in a new ride, driving the 91 car this year, with rookie driver Sylvain LeSauvage going for a pass into turn one, an aggressive move there. That's the other Dodge Challenger machine. His teammate Lucas Knight near the front of the field. Thus far, Daniel Voiles has made a few passes since we last checked in on him. Lily Gordon not having a great first effort in the 83 car. Henrietta Fitzwater made up a few positions, but again, still not too much. Elba Wanderley, a Brazilian driver, has entered for this year and is currently in the 16 Canadian Tire Ford Mustang as we head down into turn four. Could be the first South American driver we've ever seen in HARC, so interesting to see how she does over the course of the year. And Sydney Krasta back here as well. Demir Bejanov, I thought he was making his way forward, apparently not. 13 really struggling here in the early going. Mike Doan alongside the 99 as they entered Moss Corner, still side by side on the exit and down the Andretti straightaway. This is definitely slowing them down, and it's creating quite a pack behind them. Skyla Johnson, though, goes with the 72. Please don't look to make it three wide. There's not room there. Don't do that. Just don't. Just don't. But he doesn't. Sure, she doesn't. Luckily enough, Doan forced to run the outside by the 29. And Skyla Johnson continues and finishes, actually, completes her charge to the front by taking the lead here as we approach lap 20 and the only set of pit stops we're likely to see this race. On board the rear of Carl and Dumian, couple of rows of two wide racing. Bill Littlejohn trying to make his way up a couple of spots, takes a look on the outside. Heading into Clayton Corner on the 72, makes some contact with the 72. The 72 runs a bit wide in that corner, and Littlejohn, I don't think, meant to turn him there, because Littlejohn fell back several positions trying to get on the brakes there. Really sucks for the 72 of Mike Doney, who's having a great day today. Up until this point, had led the most laps, but in the end, things not just going his way this race, just as they didn't last year in the season finale, where he came into the race as the points leader and came out with coming third in the championship. We'll have to see if Mike Doan can make a bit of a recovery after pit stops, but I'm sure that aerodynamic damage to the rear end is certainly not going to help his efforts. Skyla Johnson holds a 2-car length lead as we are at the halfway point of the race at about right now, round lap 19, as Matthew Nicholson has actually made his way into second position. He fell back at the beginning of the race to nearly the bottom of the top 10, but it appears he was just saving his stuff, because now he has made a charge back to the front in a real hurry and is now closing in on the 29 for the lead. Could contend for that near the end of this lap if he keeps going like this. Carlin Dumian still holding on to third. Reddington and Harris side by side. Harris, another one of those drivers charging his way towards the front. He could compete for the victory today if he continues racing like he has been the last few laps. And what a way to get your first career win it would be for him if he could do that. Went winless in his rookie campaign last year, but the Manitoba driver looking to start off the year strong. Here comes the 43 up on the 29. No, the 29 is able to slip right back in front of the 43, despite the 43 having a great run off of Moss Corner. Really shows the power under the hood of that Fingai Saitomi Motorsports machine. The other driver, Jeffrey Fingai, the partial team owner, is in the American Tour, so it'll be interesting to see what he does as they race in their first race coming up shortly, I believe, in the next few days or weeks at the very least. Ellie Nelson continues to lose positions, trying to get one back from John King as we speak, though. Nelson appeared pretty strong early on, but now she's turned off the road after contact between John King and Gavin Moore sends her off the racing surface at a pretty incredible save to avoid hitting the tires there. Watch out with the merge there. Jim Mack has to take evasive action there. Pretty good effort by him as Matthew Stringer drives off the racing surface for some reason. I think he was just a little bit scared trying to get back on without spinning his tires too much, and is going to lose a ton of spots. Actually there, Benoit Irvine goes by in the 15 machine. Skyla Johnson's speed has actually kind of broken up the field a little bit here. We're back into just the top six battle for the lead. Mostly the guys behind her have generally just had to draft her down the straightaway in one single file train. Unlike the kind of two wide racing we've been seeing so far in the first half of the race, but Reddington appears to be the exception here. His pure speed through that corner allowed him to get alongside the 29, and although he's ahead right now, it's that last part of the gear train where the 29 really shows the speed that she has, nearly able to clear the 99 into turn 8, but the 99 still sticks his nose in and somehow gets that thing turned in. Some really great handling for the CAA Motorsports machine so far this race. As we begin pit stops, that's Gavin Moore in from 6th position. He had a strong first stint, making his way up from at least the teens up to 6th position there. Had to really get through a lot of traffic there and battle a lot of drivers to get where he is. He could be one to watch in the last few laps, along with Reddington and Johnson, who if they have some pretty good pit stops, could just drive away with this thing. Gerald Reddington vastly misses the apex, got real tight through Moss Corner, and as a result, Skyla Johnson back on the inside, and it's here that we see the absolute power once again that 29 car possesses. It took the entire straightaway, plus the S's, for the 99 to get the position from the 29 from an identical starting spot the previous lap, and already halfway down the straightaway, the 29 leads the 99 by a few car lengths, and it's Carlin Dumoulin who might get back into second with this, a little bit of contact into that corner, 99 able to save it from going off. Luckily, these guys have kept things pretty green and clean so far this race, and Johnson chooses to pit, pretty wise decision from the lead at the end of lap number 22, I do believe, and Reddington re-inherits the lead, Lil Jon in second, Nicholson back into a podium spot. Harris had a phenomenal pit stop and ends up coming out with the lead. Phil Littlejohn, another driver with a pretty good pit stop, he comes out second, but he's having some trouble getting that car into gear. Coming up the hill on the Mario Andretti straightaway, really holding up the one of Carlin Dumoulin, finally gets to the inside. Now the 10 might split the 30 if he's not careful. The 10 backs off, luckily, as the 30 nearly gets into the one. I think Littlejohn was preparing to get passed by the 10 there. Some good maneuvers by the 30 to try and let that happen. Despite, I'm sure, being frustrated for missing that shift, he's going to come out third. Gavin Moore just nearly turned the 30 around, though, as the 31 of Prudence Littlejohn and Matthew Stringer continue with their pit stops. Mike Doan has made it up a few positions. He had to pit at the end of lap number 19 for that damaged wing. Skylar Johnson and him just made some contact through that corner. They saved it. Once again, Jim Mack is going to try and get by the 29. The 29 has some rear damage, actually. I think something might have happened to him. Still waiting for some drivers to complete their pit stops, but off of pit lane already. We have a great battle between the drivers in the top four. Skylar Johnson continues with the lead. She's alongside Carlin Dumoulin. DJ Harris currently sitting right behind the 29, though, and it's Gavin Moore in the 10, currently in fourth. Johnson with the lead as they go by. A bunch of drivers having come in on lap number 24. Harris to the inside and grabs the lead very easily. Johnson still trying to get some heat in those tires, coming up on Matthew Nicholson. Now as Skylar Johnson gets turned around by Gavin Moore. And I think again that was accidental. Johnson moved up the racetrack just a little bit. Not as much damage as Doan got from his spin earlier in the race. But Johnson put well back and is probably not going to be able to contend for the race lead any longer. Although that car still has phenomenal straight line speed, I think that it's going to hurt her aerodynamics, and that could prevent her from making quite as many moves as she was doing before the pit stop. Lots of time behind the leaders as well now. Bill Littlejohn managed to merge in front of these guys from his pit stop, but he's having some trouble getting that thing up through the gears now. For whatever reason, Carlin Dumoulin trying to get by the 30, really holding the one car up as we speak. Harris with a huge lead, and Gavin Moore takes a look to the inside to try and make it three wide. He backs out of that in a real hurry. Really good job by the 10 to realize that that was nearly a death wish there. And good on the 30 for, well, trying to let him by, actually. He nearly merged into Dumoulin down that straightaway, trying to give the 10 that position. Gavin Moore's not done. As he gets into the 30 a little bit, again, they managed to save it. That's the second time Littlejohn nearly got spun out of this race already. Littlejohn needs to get that thing going. I think he's got that thing finally in the proper gear for the fast parts of this track, and he should be good to go for now. But Harris is out in front over Dumoulin. Littlejohn third, Moore fourth, and that is Gerald Reddington out in fifth position. Lucas Knight, though, in the eight, trying to come along the outside. I'm sure the 99 still trying to get that thing up through the gears and trying to get some heat into those tires. The first lap out for everyone is pretty darn slow. That's Jonathan King in the 01. Trying to make a move on the 99, stays behind for now, might make a move on the exit of 5, no! Runs wide through that corner. It's Annie Thomas making a move to the inside, along with Matthew Nicholson, might follow her through if the 93 can get a run up the hill. Reddington, along with Prudence Littlejohn and Joshua Sekouli, really pushed their cars to the absolute edge of what is possible on a set of tires and a fuel load, pushing their cars all the way to the end of lap 25. Reddington paid for it, of course, by posting some of the slowest laps of any driver out there on track, and now he's well behind the leader, but he's going to have the freshest tires getting into the final lap, so it'll be interesting to see whether Reddington can close in on that lead once we get to around five laps to go. Doan pitted on lap 19, and as a result, he is currently back up into the top 20, although he's definitely got the least fresh tires on the track, and it's going to be a bit of a struggle for him for the rest of the race as he continues on that set of tires and being a bit slow with the aerodynamics problem. But Santa Cruz had a pretty bad pit stop, was falling back just before the pit stops as well, and now she is out of the race. She was having a great run to start the day, but engine issues drop her out of the race with 12 laps to go. Surprisingly enough, Allie Nelson and Skyla Johnson have recovered quite well from their respective spins earlier on in the race. They're up to 11th and 12th, still sitting 12 seconds behind the leader. Got a lot of work to do in these final laps if they're going to compete for the victory. I don't know whether it's going to be possible, but these two could easily get inside the top 10, I imagine, depending on how this stint goes for them. Michael Kane having a hell of a run today. Earlier on, I thought we saw him around 20th or 30th place, now up into 13th spot. Brandon Krasta, as consistent as always, sitting 14th. Johnny Appleseed having a pretty solid day in 15th. And Jim Mack was sitting at the bottom of the top 30 earlier on, currently sitting around 16th spot. So, I mean, he's having a pretty good day after all, it appears, in that number 5 Sobeys machine. Harlan Dumian runs wide through turn 5, and here comes Gavin Moore for the lead down the Andretti straightaway. Got a long time to go up this straight, and just behind their racing as well for position, DJ Harris has lost the lead and is currently in third. Bill Littlejohn might be taking a look to the outside, which would be very interesting. Yes, he is, in fact. I'm not sure whether he's going to be able to get anything done up there, but nice to see Littlejohn up there trying something different. Gavin Moore and Carlin Dumian still side by side. Lucas Knight trying to follow the 30 through the 30, actually manages to get into third. Very impressive move by Bill Littlejohn. They're crashing behind him. That's DJ Harris around after contact with Lucas Knight and John King, trying to merge back on the racetrack. No, he slams into the pit wall. He can't get that thing turned in time. He was trying not to lose that much time from that incident, but instead that will take him clean out of the race. We see Santa Cruz coming back to her pit stop, finally, after blowing an engine in turn number 3 a couple of minutes ago, really. Annie Thomas has now merged, is now back inside the top 5 in that 93. Got quite a gap to close, as does Gerald Reddington, but Gerald Reddington's tires really starting to come in now. He hasn't really closed in on the top two as of yet, but he's now sitting in fourth. He has less traffic to deal with, and that could be just what he needs, coming to around 10 laps to go. Matthew Nicholson currently in sixth. Lucas Knight is still on the racing surface, still sitting actually in around seventh place, but I think his aero is really hurting him on the Andretti straightaway. He's got a real stack up of cars behind him. That's Mike Wisnowski that got by him, Michael Kane by him, and now Skyla Johnson in the 29 going by. That's Jim Mack in the wall after contact with Matt Duncan, and Harris gets collected in that one as well. That's his second wreck in the last two laps. Not been the best of times this stint for Harris, nor has it been for Duncan, as Doan slips along the inside, picks up a few positions. That is Martinez running along the outside. Be careful there, buddy. Runs a little bit into the grass there, struggling for grip in turn two as a result, and quite a stack up of cars. A lot of battling is going to go on in the next lap or two, I imagine, with all these drivers running so close. You could probably fit six or seven of these guys under a blanket at the moment. That's Sylvian Lasavage in the 88, just behind Lily Gordon in the 83, Sawyer Girl trying to make his way forward a few positions, as is James Shelley. Duncan trying to recover from that crash. He doesn't have a ton of damage, so I think he'll be okay. The 72 of Doan might stack these guys up pretty bad. I'm sure his aerodynamics, again, aren't exactly helping him down the Mario Andretti straightaway. My God, Demir Bezhenov has come out of nowhere. He must have had one hell of a pit stop in that 13, probably made some good adjustments, because now he is up into the top 20, as is Benoit Irvine in the 15, having a great end of the day. It'll be interesting to see where he ends up at the completion of this race. The race is definitely on for 18th on back. Duncan and Shelley side by side. Shelley's made up some spots as of recently. That's Irvine going by Bezhenov. What a drive again for him, as he continues to make his way by some of the most experienced drivers in the HARC Canada field. That is Martinez driving by Duncan now, and Voyles going by. Maybe Duncan has some more damage than I thought he did. Either that or he might just be falling back to see if he can get back into a rhythm, but we'll have to see. Behind them, very close, raising some near contact there between the 16 of Wanderley and the 01 of Sawyer Girl and the 88 of Lesavage. And Lily Gordon goes for a dive into turn number three. That's Quebec corner, and trying to hold him off on the outside is Lesavage. Yes, she, I think, is able to do so. And the 16 goes for a dive up the inside. Sawyer Girl with a defensive, very defensive line into turn five, and will likely come out still holding on to that position. The 16 good through the middle of the corner, but the 01 great on exit there. Prudence, Littlejohn, and Henrietta Fitzwater racing for a position. Where the hell did Fitzwater come from? In the 61, still hasn't quite made it into the top 20, but certainly an improvement from her 40th position running effort earlier in the day. So good job for her. Poor and Carl and Dumian are very evenly matched, it appears, and Dumian might just be a slight bit faster, but Gavin Moore seems to be a little bit more aggressive. Never mind, and Dumian with a charge through turn four is not able to make that move stick. Almost no one's been able to pass on the outside coming into turn five, so it was probably a good idea for an Dumian to get out of the gas. Littlejohn is currently in third, but simply can't seem to keep pace with those top two. And here comes Reddington by. Reddington has been setting laps consistently about 1 second faster than the top two, but just five laps to go, so he's gonna have to get there and hurry. And once he does, he's gonna have to get by those two very hungry drivers. He got by Annie Thomas a couple of laps ago in the 93. She was also closing, is now actually falling back now in these final few laps. Shame for her. She was having a pretty solid effort today after dealing with a lot of traffic earlier on at the bottom of the top 10. Dumian and Moore once again side by side through turn number one. Less than six laps to go at this point for these two drivers. One with a lot of experience, that being in Dumian. He's won three races in his career, two of them at road courses, one of them at Road America. Well, I'd say actually all of them at road courses. Well, depending on whether you consider Walton a road course, is closer to a super speedway in many people's opinion, but does have both left and right-handed corners, so you can give it that at least. But he's also won at Donington Park back in 2014 in a photo finish with Matthew Nicholson, who ironically is running in ninth position. Wow, Nicholson's really fallen back in these recent laps, even might lose a position to that of Lucas Knight with that very damaged eight car. He's holding on for dear life to a top 10 spot as we speak. But the other track that Dumian won at was Road America, and that was not too long ago. The second to last round, the penultimate round of the 2015 HARC Pro Series season, Dumian won there, holding off Kim Markell for several laps. But here comes Moore with another dive up the inside. Moore, of course, a rookie. We don't know a ton about Moore. I'm assuming Moore is an American driver. I think it is. I think he is at the very least. But having, making a good impression in his first start under that Napa sponsorship, going at it with one of the series veterans, Carl Endumian, still side by side with Endumian, and I'm sure this is helping. That of Reddington, Bill Littlejohn, has picked up the pace very suddenly in the 30 and is racing Reddington quite hard. That's not what Reddington wants, and I'm sure that's not what Littlejohn wants. I think Littlejohn should just pull in behind Reddington so that they can team up and perhaps go after these top two. As the laps continue to wind down, they're both now charging up towards these top two. Duncan still struggling to hold on to a top 20. He's got some serious left side damage that I just didn't see before. And now he's made some contact with Sawyer Girl. Sawyer Girl into the back of the 99, runs a bit wide. The 99 tried to go a bit defensive there. And the 99 into the tire wall. The 01 slides back on the racetrack. Prudence Littlejohn with some damage. At least Sawyer managed to avoid the pit wall. But Girl's gonna have some damage, as does Prudence Littlejohn now. They're both gonna be able to continue. Relatively minor. I don't think they're gonna have to make a pit stop. That's a real shame for Littlejohn. She was starting to make up a couple of spots, I think. Their Doan really falling back now in these later laps, as is Mark Nutt, who continues to race out there with that rear end damage from the lap one collision with Aiden Shepherd. Couple of new drivers racing side by side down the Andretti straightaway. These guys are giving it their all on these final laps, even if it's just for a position in the mid-teens, as Elva Wanderley gets by for that spot, and Johnny Martinez gets sent around after contact with Daniel Voiles. It makes a small impact with the tire wall. His rear end is ruined like so many others. In this race, he manages to merge onto the track relatively safely, just in front of Joshua Sekula in the 07, who's immediately going to get to the inside of him. Luca Obrovac here as well, as is Spencer Fullerton. That's Alex Tanker having not the best of runs, and Nicholas Guerra also back here. Carl Endumian and Gavin Moore once again side by side through turn number two. Morse tries to squeeze Endumian all the way down past the white line. In fact, they make a little bit of contact through there. They keep things clean and green into Quebec corner. And all the meanwhile, Reddington and Littlejohn are closing in on those top two. They're still side by side out of Quebec corner. Incredible racing for that spot we've seen over the course of the last 5 to 10 laps. They've traded the lead multiple times. And Reddington has made his way by Littlejohn in turn one earlier this lap. Littlejohn, though, I'm surprised that he has actually made a charge back towards the front. He seemed to be losing those top two, but I think it might just be the draft or something. But he's actually losing some time to the top three as we speak. He's a few car lengths behind. He's got to make sure he stays within drafting distance of these top three. Not sure whether he's having some trouble getting up through the gears or not. But under the Canadian Tire sign, we're coming to two laps to go. And Reddington with a charge on the 10 through the corner. They both run wide, both the leader and second place. And Endumian and Moore both run wide. And now Reddington's alongside Endumian. I told you Reddington was going to have some of the strongest tires due to coming in so late for his pit stop. And of course, he showed earlier on just how strong that 99 car is. And he leads at the line. Can he clear Endumian through turn number one? Yes, he's got him. And Endumian slips in just behind the 99. He might try to make a look into turn number two. He does not want Reddington getting too far in front of him, I imagine. But Endumian falls back from the 99's bumper just a little bit, runs wide through Quebec corner, the 10, with a great run through there. A really good effort by Gavin Moore to perhaps get into second, as they're still too wide. Coming through turn four, Moore is going to have the optimal line into Moss corner, and Littlejohn seems to have picked back up the pace. Not sure if he's just waiting right now, but he's got to start making his way to the front if he's going to challenge these guys for the race victory. In another lap and a half or so, less than that now, I bet. Gavin Moore back alongside the 99. I was not expecting that. I was expecting Reddington to just pull away from Moore and Endumian down the Andretti straightaway. Carl Endumian is actually following Reddington. I was not expecting that. I was expecting him to help Moore along the inside. But I think Endymion just wants to end up back into second place so that he's in an optimal position to challenge Reddington down the Andretti straightaway next lap, the most important lap of this race. Little John into the grass. He's got a tire going down in that number 30 car, and he's going to have to pit that car. A real shame for him. He had a nearly perfect race, other than a little bit of contact with a driver earlier on, lost some positions, made his way back up though, and with a good pit stop, he looked like he was going to contend for this race victory. Ultimately though, he's going to struggle to get a top 20, it does appear. Johnny Appleseed has crashed, we'll take a look at that in just a minute, but Gavin Moore and Carl Endymion have fallen back now from Reddington. They were battling very hard for that position. We'll check back in on the lead battle in just a few seconds. Matthew Nicholson and Johnny Appleseed were racing very hard for the ninth position. They bump heading into turn eight. Alex Wheeler accidentally runs a little bit wide and they just simply can't get off of one another. Appleseed into the tire wall. That kills that car's engine and he's out of the race. Alex Wheeler manages to save that car miraculously after driving that thing through the grass and getting it real sideways. Continental Tire sign, Reddington goes through turn four and up through turn five for the very final time. If Gavin Moore can get a good run through turn five, he might just have one final shot at Reddington. No, Carl Endymion gets to the inside of the 10 as Moore runs wide, but I think it's too little too late. Endymion needs to clear Moore very quickly if he's going to have one last shot at Reddington, but Reddington with a 10 car length lead as we're halfway down the back straightaway. Reddington has won four races so far in his career, three of them at road courses, so it's no surprise to see him back up front when it counts here at Canadian Tire Motorsports Park through the S's for the final time. And it appears Reddington's going to start off this year with a bang, just as he did last year, winning three races in the opening nine rounds through White's Corner. And Reddington is going to come across the line to win HARC Canada race number one in 2016 at Canadian Tire Motorsports Park with a great pit strategy and some phenomenal passes in those final laps to get the job done. Carl Endymion with a very close second. He battled the last 10 laps with Gavin Moore. I don't think he could have expected Reddington to get there in time, but still a very strong effort from Endymion, leading around 10 laps today. Gavin Moore, what a run for him in his very first race ever, a podium finish. I don't think he could have wanted more, although I'm sure he wanted to battle Reddington for that spot, for the lead on the final lap. Brandon Krasta, didn't really talk about him in the final few laps, was too focused on that battle for the lead, but fourth spot for him. What a phenomenal effort for him today. After starting 21st, Michael Kane, probably his best run ever there in the 75 car, this is his third year in park competition. Lucas Knight in the 8 car, what an effort by him. He looked like he was dropping positions. He actually managed to pick up some in those final laps to finish 6th. Skyla Johnson, what a recovery from her spin into the turn 2 wall earlier on to finish 7th. 8th is Annie Thomas in the 93. Looked like she was going to follow Reddington up to the front, but just didn't seem to have the car for that, it appeared, in those final few laps. Allie Nelson in the Denali Tanana after spinning off the road and nearly hitting the tire wall earlier on. A great finish for her. And Matthew Nicholson rounds out the top 10 in the 43 car.